What is an instrument? Well, an instrument is a tool especially for work. And as children, we must work hard by sharing the word of God with our friends and family. And just like we must be willing to work hard in our education so that we can pass our exams. And we must listen to the advice of our parents the same way we've listened to the advice of Naomi. So in chapter 1 it says, long ago, the days before Israel had a king, there was a famine in the land. So a man named Elimelech went with his wife Naomi and the two sons to live for a while in the country of Moab. But while they were living there, Elimelech died and Naomi was left alone with their two sons. He married Moabite woman, Orpah and Ruth. About 2 years later, Naomi's two sons also died, and Naomi was left alone without a husband or son. So what I just read, you can see that Naomi, though when she came to Moab, she was with her family. Now she's all left alone without a husband or two sons. So some time later, Naomi heard that the Lord has blessed his people, so she got ready to leave Moab with her daughters and all. And she said to them, go back home and stay with your mothers. May the Lord be as good to you as you have been to me and to those who have died. And may the Lord make it possible for each of you to marry again and have a home for yourselves. So Naomi is struggled by it, but they saw her crying and said to her, no, we'll go with you to your people. You must go back, my daughters, Naomi answered. Why do you want to come with me? Again they started crying. Then Orpah kissed her mother-in-law goodbye and went back home. But Ruth held on to her. So Naomi said to her, Ruth, your sister-in-law has gone back to her people and to her God. Go back home with her. But Ruth answered, don't ask me to leave you. Let me go with you. Wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you live, I will live. Your people will be my people, and your God will be my God. Wherever you die, I will die, and that is where I will be buried. May the Lord's worst pleasure come upon me if I let anything but death separate from you. So you can see that Ruth was determined to come with Naomi on a journey back to Bethlehem. She wasn't thinking about herself like Orpah. She didn't go back to her family and started a new one. She knew that how much Naomi has been through ever since she's lost her family, and she knew that she needs someone by her side. So when we put this into our real lives, it's important that we also think about other people other than ourselves.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
They moved right on until they came to Bethlehem. Naomi also had a relative named Boaz, a rich and influential man who belonged to the family. So one day Ruth said to Naomi, let me go to the fields to gather the corn that the harvest workers need. I'm sure to find someone who will let me work with him. Naomi answered, go ahead, my daughter. So you could also see that she was also willing to work off to provide food for her and Naomi. And us children, it's important that we also work hard for us to reach our achievements. Amen?
Amen.
So sometime later, Boaz himself arrived from Bethlehem and greeted the workers. Then the man answers, Boaz asked the man in charge, who is that young woman? He answered, she is the young woman from Moab who came back with Naomi. She asked me to let her follow the workers and pick up the corn. She has been working since early morning and has just now stopped to rest for a while under the shelter. The worker said to him, "Let me give you some advice. Don't pick up corn anywhere except in this field. Work for the woman here. Watch them to see where they are reaping and stay with them. I've ordered my men not to molest you, and whenever you are thirsty, go and drink from the water jars that they have filled. So if we do sacrifices for people, maybe they may not be able to pay us back, but God who is in heaven, he is able to see our kindness and he's able to see our kindness we've shown to people, and that's how we get our blessings from God. Amen.
Amen.
The roof fell down with her first touch to the ground and said to God, "Why should you be concerned about me? Why should you be kind to such a foreigner?" God answered, "I have heard about everything that you have done for your mother and mother since your husband died. I know how you left your father and mother and your own country and how you came to live among people you have never been before. May the Lord reward you for what you have done. May you have a full reward from the Lord, God of Israel, to whom you have come for protection." So, as children of God, we must also learn to listen to the advice of our parents, so that it will be well with us. And as children of God, we should be willing to show kindness to everybody, especially when it seems that they can never pay us back. Just as Ruth decided to show kindness to Naomi when she knew that she was old and poor. When we are able to do that, God who sees everything will come round and reward us. Amen.
Amen.